The United Kingdom warns Russia of severe economic sanctions as it accuses the Kremlin of planning to install a puppet regime in Ukraine. Details in this report.
Britain has accused the Kremlin of seeking to install a pro-Russian leader in Ukraine. The UK's foreign ministry declined to provide evidence to back up its claims, which come at a time of heightened tensions between Russia and the West. Russia has massed troops at its border with Ukraine, but insists it has no plans to invade. In a statement, Britain's Foreign Office said it had information that the Russian government was eyeing former Ukrainian lawmaker Yevhen Muraev to potentially head a pro-Russian leadership. Muraev, who opposes Ukraine's integration with the West, described the British Foreign Office as seeming confused. He told the Observer newspaper that the statement isn't very logical, adding that he is banned from Russia. The Russian Foreign Ministry dismissed the comments as disinformation and accused Britain and NATO of escalating tensions. The UK also said it had information that Russian intelligence services were maintaining links with numerous former Ukrainian politicians, including senior figures linked to ex-president Viktor Yanukovych, who fled to Russia in 2014 after 3 months of protests. The British claims come a day after top US and Russian diplomats failed to make a breakthrough in discussions to resolve the crisis. They have agreed to keep talking. Russia has made demands on the US, including a halt to NATO's eastward expansion and a pledge that Ukraine will never be allowed to join the Western military alliance. A UK foreign ministry source said it was not usual practice to share intelligence matters, and that the details had only been declassified after careful consideration in order to deter Russian aggression. The office of UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson also said he was planning to ramp up pressure on Russia this week, by calling for European counterparts to come together with the United States.
A South African court has postponed a ruling on a lawsuit seeking to stop the construction of Amazon's new headquarters on what's being claimed as sacred land. The proposed development in Cape Town includes plans for a hotel, homes and retail offices with Amazon as its main tenant. But it has faced backlash from Khoi and San community leaders. The building site lies in the confluence of two rivers that is sacred to both groups. The Khoi and San were the earliest inhabitants of South Africa.
This matter, all things being even and justice being served, we know for us today and for the seven generations into the future for whom we are responsible, we have established a very significant precinct for the praxis of First Nations cultures. And that was the beginning, that is the beginning of a liberated zone from which we will never step away from our responsibilities to our people.
Developers have argued, though, they have fulfilled all regulatory requirements for the project, adding it will lead to investments and jobs in a country where a third of its people are out of work. Now, dozens of people who've arrived in Beijing for the Winter Olympics test positive for COVID-19. Beijing Olympic organizers confirmed there were 72 cases among the more than 2,500 Games-related personnel that entered China from January 4th to the 22nd. 39 were found during testing at the airport and 33 inside a closed loop, which separates all event personnel from the public. None of the athletes or team officials who arrived during the same period were sick. Final preparations are taking place for the Games amid a global surge in cases, and officials are using a playbook to ensure there will be no outbreak during the event. The Winter Olympics are set to take place from February 4 to the 20th.
New Zealand again showing an abundance of caution following the detection of a cluster of Omicron cases. A family who returned to the south from the North Island tested positive after attending a wedding. A flight attendant also caught the virus. This prompted the country to shift to a red setting, imposing mask rules and limiting gatherings. Even Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern has cancelled her own wedding as the new restrictions take effect.
As for mine, my wedding will not be going ahead, but I just join many other New Zealanders who have had an experience like that as a result of the pandemic, and to anyone who's caught up in that scenario, I'm so sorry, but we are all so resilient, and I know we understand that we're doing this for one another, and I know that will help us continue on. Oh, such is life. Our plan is simple: get boosted, wear a mask in indoor settings and outdoors when you can't distance from others, and reduce contacts as much as practical in those environments. Omicron is now in more than 80 countries around the world. By delaying its arrival here, we've had the time to kick off boosters, vaccination for children, and prepare.
New Zealand's borders have been shut to foreigners since March 2020, and plans for a phased reopening from mid-January have been pushed back to the end of February. About 94% of New Zealand's population over the age of 12 is fully vaccinated, and about 56% of those eligible have had booster shots.
The culling of hamsters in Hong Kong continues. As this report tells us, one hamster surrendered to local authorities tested positive for COVID-19.
Hong Kong authorities on Sunday said one hamster surrendered by pet owners had tested positive for the COVID-19 virus, while over 2,200 hamsters had been culled as the city grappled to contain an outbreak. On Tuesday, officials ordered the killing of hamsters from dozens of pet stores after tracing a coronavirus outbreak to a worker at a shop. People were asked to surrender any hamsters bought on or after December 22nd. While a handful had already tested positive for the virus, this latest case is the first involving a hamster in the care of a pet owner that had tested positive. Despite a public outcry against the crackdown, authorities urged pet owners to continue to hand over their tiny furry pets, given the increasing health risks. The government described the outcry as irrational. In response, thousands of people have offered to adopt unwanted hamsters. Meanwhile, 140 new infections were reported in Hong Kong on Sunday, and there are no signs of the government easing the restrictions.